I've been wandering these creek beds and hills all my life, I guess, ever since I was big enough to walk.
The wanderers, the dreamers, the curious, caught up in a never-ending quest for untold riches. For more than 100 years, folks have scaled the rolling granite hills of Mason County, anxiously searching for some of Earth's most ancient treasures. When Wilburn Shearer was a boy, his daddy brought him out to this creek bed, and he's never looked up from the ground since.
It's usually a flake off of a large piece of flint that the Indians flaked off theirself. I always call it a sliver. Thinking about some old Indian that was doing it 2,000 or 3,000 years ago possibly, and how he was sitting maybe in the same place, chipping one like that I was doing at the same time. I never keep an arrowhead that I make. I don't want to get them mixed up with anything that I find. And I always give them away. Every arrowhead that I've ever made, I've given it away.
If that's so, then Wilburn's given away thousands of arrowheads in his day. No matter, there's always enough flint to chip another point, and it only takes a few minutes. But arrowheads, says Wilburn, are a dime a dozen compared to the Earth's real treasure.
I had to wear shoulder braces when I was a kid because I walked around stoop-shouldered, looking at the ground all the time, no telling what you might find. Lots of pretty rocks, but not what we're looking for.
It's like finding a teardrop on the moon. No other Texas stone has as much mystery and allure as the topaz. And the crown jewel of the topaz is the Mason County variety, seeing as how you'd be hard-pressed to find it anywhere other than right here in one of these creek beds.
There's quartz. Here's what we're looking for. Right there. There's no feeling like it, really. I can imagine what a gold miner feels when he finds a big gold nugget or something. But there's no feeling like it, really. It's kind of like a poor man's diamond. I just admire the beauty of them, how God could create something out of a rock that turned out so pretty.
Crystal clear and at times so tiny, the Mason County topaz represents some of the oldest rocks in the world. Hailed as powerful medicine among the Indians, pioneers called it desert ice, a mysterious mixture of both fire and frozen time trapped in a rugged crystal. When Wilburn begins his meticulous sculpting process, he puts something else into the ancient precious stones.
This is what they want. They want the Lone Star cut. People come into the town and they're looking for the Lone Star cut. They're looking for Mason County topaz too. They want topaz from Mason County. They want the Lone Star cut. It's what makes it unique.
Only a handful of stone cutters in the world have the steady hand to facet this most intricate cut, the Lone Star. Like some great visual illusion, the Star of Texas seems to float inside an ageless rock. For years, Wilburn's been cutting what's now become the official state gemstone.
Some people seem to think that when you look into the stone and see the reflection of the star, you're actually seeing the reflection of your eye. It's rare. One time there was quite a bit of it, but every year there gets to be less and less. It's not being remade.
just enjoy, after I cut one, somebody else enjoying it. It's not so much me enjoying it, it's I just enjoy somebody else admiring it, liking it, and appreciating it.
So tiny a stone and so steady a hand. One small slip-up could ruin a precious and rare gift from the earth. When Wilburn Shearer transforms his own slow and gentle nature to a precious topaz, a star is plucked from the heavens and forever locked in an eternal brilliance. And at that moment, Wilburn has touched the heart of every Texan.
Everybody ought to have a Mason County Lone Star cut topaz, because someday they're not going to be any, they're going to all be gone.